Hello, right. Facebook world. Tom Tryon here. We are here with the wonderful Dr. Devich, and she wanted to tell you a little bit about our campus here and all the wonderful things that are happening and her beautiful garden that she manicures with the kids. And also, some wonderful trees were brought into 96th Street.
Yes,
and was there
anything
brought in here?
Yeah, yes, I'll show you.
Okay, she's going to give you a tour.
We brought in some Arizona milkweed. It's part of a whole having Arizona to be a feeding station for monarch butterflies who are endangered. So that's what we did today. We set that up. But look over here. We have, look at all our adorable little peaches. And they are blooming out. They're fabulous. Yep, they're all fuzzy. They'll be ready to eat in about 3 weeks.
So can you tell me about these peaches, though? Like, are these indigenous to Arizona?
Not really. No fruit trees, but they're very, very happy. No, not this particular type of fruit of peach trees.
Now, have you had one of these before? Are they juicy and yummy?
Yes. And we cut everything back in the tree. The whole tree was laden with them 2 years ago, so, yeah.
Oh, wow.
And peach trees kind of take a little break in between.
Oh, okay.
So,
give us the full tour. Let's see all this.
Look at this today. Yes. I hope you can scope in here and see. This is our sustainable pond. Look at the bees there. Bees, we come in.
Why don't you let this... Thanks for tuning in here. We're with Dr. Heather. If you're just tuning in, we see that there's somebody with us here. And Dr. Heather is giving us a tour of her beautiful sustainable systems area, garden.
Now, this is a water purification pond. It's all the plants themselves that put the oxygen into the water. We have floating plants that take out heavy metals. This has been sitting here for like... Who knows? Yeah, it's lasted like about 5 years.
Wow.
So.
And the kids built all this,
yes,
right?
Yes, they did. They did everything. And we just put in our fish over here. We have goldfish. We have snails. We have every kind of lovely bees and dragonflies. We just put in our, let's see, they're probably hiding under some leaves here. We have lily pads. We have cattails. We have parrot feather. And the basis of all of it is our anacris grass. It's seaweed, and it puts all the oxygen into the water. Oops, here it is. There you go. Yep. And it just floats. And then this is some actual, we don't eat it at school, but this is edible hair algae. You think it's
green? Oh, wow.
Not in the least. It feels exactly like hair. You want to feel it?
Sure.
This is, yeah.
Oh, it sure does.
So if I could ask a question. So with today being Earth Day, could you just give a quick synopsis how this sort of educational component connects to the future of the students?
Absolutely. This is really a system of how our whole ocean works that keeps itself going. It's really the photoplankton putting the oxygen into the water to begin with. The only thing we do to this, nothing goes into it. All we do is, like today, the kids squirted some water up into the air,
mm-hmm.
so that the chlorine dissipated out in the atmosphere, and then coming down, the drops actually dissolved oxygen into the water and into the drops. That's all we do. We add nothing to this. The insects, the animals that are in here, they just eat the roots. This is like a little tiny microcosm of the earth itself. Now over here we have our lovely pomegranates. This is a beautiful tree.
Sure
it
is.
Just bloomed out. Aha, look right here. We have these are right here. These are the pomegranates.
Well, it's a little, little pomegranate there.
Isn't that adorable?
Wow. Yeah.
So this is just a whole prolific tree. Isn't it lovely?
Yeah.
Now you couldn't eat that right now, right?
No. This will be ready really in the fall. This teeny tiny demonstration is an arid farming demonstration that the city of Scottsdale spent hundreds of millions of dollars on either side of our school doing the same thing, because basins, berms, and swales collect and direct the water.
Mm.
And so all the Native Americans who lived here, we have followed the same type of irrigation that they use. So when the rain comes down from here, off the roof, but the roof is inclined a little bit, so this is a major place. We looked to figure out the major place where all the rain came down. This is a basin of rocks. It's only about 4 feet of rocks down in there. It completely stops any runoff,
mm-hmm.
so you don't have soil erosion, and you have water that percolates down into the aquifer.
This would probably all be gone if that wasn't there, right?
Yeah.
Washed out.
Yeah. And that happens. Figure this happening. It's a lot happening around the world in floods now.
Sure.
Because the major rain, just like flooding over, washes everything away, and then you have food problems, you have health problems, everything. Also here, everything we do is try to conserve water. So these swales direct the water. The rain comes down, it goes into the aquifer. When this basin kind of fills up, then it spills over here and it goes out, and you can see where this has happened today. And it then the basins that are around our fig tree, a beautiful, beautiful fig tree, and around our beautiful pomegranate, the basins around them are then filled so that, again, you're holding the water where you needed to have it, and with no waste. It's pretty amazing.
Wow.
Oh, here's our windmill right there. And one of our former Montessori students, Elizabeth Maldonado, who's in engineering at ASU now. She's an honors college.
Sure.
Yeah, she's a pretty amazing young woman. She at, let's see, I think it's May the 10th, is coming to our school. And she's going to do a whole system with us. We're going to be electrifying this windmill. And just because the wind isn't blowing today, but it just really gets going. So why waste all that fabulous energy?
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
Right.
So we're going to have a copper coil in the presence of a magnetic field that will produce, that's going to produce electricity. Isn't that amazing?
Oh, that's fantastic.
We will use it to come inside our little greenhouse. This fabulous little greenhouse that the kids themselves built.
Oh, wow.
This is like a dog kennel. We put this translucent kind of material on here so that it's warm in the winter and cool in the summer. And in here, one side, we have all these herbs that we're drying here. These are from our garden. And then we just made some fabulous.
Oh, Doc,
fabulous.
Sorry to interrupt you. I think you'd be excited to know that Lauren Kenyon is actually commenting. We're live here. Mike, if you want to show her, Lauren Kenyon is tuned in to us.
Oh, good, good.
So if you're just tuning in, we're here with Dr. Heather. And please leave a comment on here and let Dr. Heather know how much we love her. And then also ask a question. You can ask a question on there, and Dr. Heather would be happy to answer about any sustainable systems.
This is our fish barrel. Oh, by the way, over there at our pond, it's in an inert butyl rubber container so that nothing ever happens. There's no rust, there's no erosion, whatever, from our pond, and there's no contamination of the water. Same with this. This is our fish barrel container.
Oh, sure.
If you can see in here, see the fish just...
There's fish in here.
Oh, look at the fish. Look at all those.
Now, what are those?
Yeah.
You know?
Oh, yeah. These are Gambusia fish. They are mosquito-eating fish. But we also have... there are snails down the side. And we have... Again, we have the anacharous grass. Let me see. I'll pull it up. There it is. Puts the oxygen into the water. Again, we have our parrot feather. And so this is a whole little ecosystem. And we're going to put tilapia fish in here.
Oh, wow.
As it all gets established. Mm-hmm. Okay. There's a bit of shade. It looks like it's dark. The water isn't dark. It's just the way the lighting is right here. Okay, so then we grow at various times of the year all kinds of medicinal herbs like our aloe vera.
Right, it's good for sunburns.
Good for a lot of things. So then our barn, our lovely barn.
I heard you had a bunch of rabbits born.
Oh yeah, we did. So the kids take care of their little, this is a little garden area for Mr. Colburn's class. The kids take care of everything here. But, love this. Okay, look over here.
I got a comment from Sage Wilson. She says, yay, no more mosquitoes.
Yes, no more mosquitoes. Yeah. So this is our sustainable pond, our duck pond. See our duck in there? This is because the ducks actually ingest mud, and duck poop is deadly as far as, it's not deadly, but that smell is pretty bad. We never have that issue at all because this is the kids fix this pond. The water, again, percolates down to the aquifer, which is around 40 feet in this area under here. This is also shaded by our, this is a Chilean mesquite tree that stays spindly. So it put itself, we planted it, it put itself up through the roof of our barn. It's spreading over, it's making a natural canopy right here. And so also the ducks love to eat these leaves. So everything, you know, we don't waste one thing. I love our little canopy here. Do you see our welcome to our farm sign? And inside, you want to look up here? We We have a solar panel up here that the kids, again, we put this up with a parent. Oh, by the way, the kids with parents built this barn entirely. And then entirely, the whole thing.
That's amazing.
We have our compost system over there. This was nothing but sand. It is now good soil. It's now good soil. I just put a little Nepali in there. And the critters are going to be eating it. The rabbits are going to come pretty soon and nibble on that. This solar panel inside of our barn runs. See those three cords coming down? We put those three cords into a conduit. See the conduit down there? We buried it. And in our greenhouse, it runs a little bitty fountain. But inside the barn, it also runs a light and a fan. Isn't that amazing?
It is amazing.
From those three panels, it's pretty amazing, yeah. And that the kids did every bit of this themselves. I'm just so proud of them.
So now I'm trying to parse through what you're saying. I hear that you're saying that you've built, now is this one giant ecosystem or is this several ecosystems?
This is basically, it's an urban homestead. It's really everything that you need to live, pretty much. We have vegetables that we grow in our biointensive garden over there where you have one quarter of the water use and you have four times the yield. That's like a demonstration garden. And then you have your fruit from the peaches, what are those guys? The pea guys down there that I just showed you, our pomegranates. And then we have protein. From inside, we have our chickens.
Oh, that's great.
I'm sorry, the barn's locked and we should go inside. But here, let's see. You see? There's one of our chickens.
Now,
right,
what's
there.
His name?
No, that's not Miss Fluffy Pants. That's Brownie. But inside, I really need to get the keys.
Hi, Brownie.
Inside, we have a whole nest.
Say hi, Brownie.
Should I go get the keys so you can see it? Okay, inside, we have a nest in there. And the kids counted the eggs today. There are about 12 eggs. And so, they have protein from the eggs. If you're on a farm, you also have your chickens.
We've got another comment in here. If Mike wants to bring this over, it says right on. This is from Lauren Kennan. Hey, Lauren, thanks for tuning in. We appreciate it. Why don't you film Dr. Heather? Why are you doing that? Because
Hi,
they don't
Lauren.
Want to stare at the gate.
Yeah.
So it says right on. I can ask you about putting hydrogels in soil as experiment. It's replacing irrigation systems around the world. To show the children a supportive ecosystem is critical to helping them be environmentally conscious.
Absolutely.
Very lovely and unique. Well, thank you for commenting, Lauren.
Thank you. Yes. What we do, the principle of what we use is do what nature does. Do what nature does, and you won't go wrong. Because there's been all kinds of unintended consequences by trying things that are really contrary to what nature does. And we end up like having horrible problems with pesticides, having horrible problems with polluting the atmosphere. All these systems are really labor intensive and they are also low tech because you're just emulating what nature does. And if you watch and observe exactly what nature does, you're never gonna have some kind of an unintended consequence
that
later on can cause really serious problems. So that's
if you could get the governments of the world and these big conglomerates doing that, we'd probably be a better place.
But what's so good for the kids is like they hear about all the problems. These are hands-on solutions for producing your own clean water, your own renewable energy, your own solar, your own biointensive gardening, your own fruits, your own vegetables, your own protein, your own fish. This is really, if you look at it, this is everything
that is amazing.
That you need. It really is. It's a little urban homestead. That's why we say, welcome to our farm.
So
and everything so carefully works all together. The kids can take one piece of it and do it at home, or they could even take all these skills. And I'm hoping they're going to last for a lifetime and how they understand that they really can take care of themselves in a way that helps the environment.
Right. And I don't think we elaborated on this earlier, but just so the audience knows kind of where we are. We are here at the upper elementary campus. So
yes.
These are the 9 to 12 year old age group kids who are learning these really valuable skills and sustainability.
Yeah. And then also with the composting, they understand about that you have, if you want to grow your garden, first you got to grow your soil. So they really understand the principle of composting. We recycle our lunches with our composting. We recycle little any waste from our rabbits. goes into our compost, and the microbial life breaks it down naturally within a very short amount of time.
And they're just chilling over there. See
yeah.
them?
All these guys are cozy.
They're comfy.
Here. The kids love them. They just love their bun buns. They're so sweet. And so, yeah, all these systems all work together. Then, whatever we produce, just today, I wish you could have tasted them. They used our solar cooker, which we cost nothing at all. We didn't pollute the atmosphere with producing any kind of electricity. It was up to 350 degrees
wow.
in our solar box cooker. And we cooked the most delicious apples. They were fabulous. Our
Did you add a little cinnamon?
Yeah, little organic cinnamon.
Yummy.
A little organic brown sugar, which is just all that is just cane sap.
Lauren says they loved your Adobe Pizza Maker 17 years ago. When...
Yes, that was hilarious. The kids made a little Adobe Orno, this small, and then we built a great big one. And we cooked, to me, it was the best pizza I ever tasted.
Mm. Did Lauren's daughter go to school here?
Yes, yeah,
this is 17 years ago when they were five.
She's 22 now, wow.
So sweet, yeah. One of our fabulous, fabulous students, yeah.
Well, we really appreciate you following the page and keeping up to date with us.
Yes, dear.
Oh, we got another one. Thank you, Manal, for tuning in. This is Manal Casa, and she says, hi, doctor, we miss you. Oh, it's Deshaun's mom.
Oh,
hi, Manal. Yes. Oh. It's Tom here with my colleague Mike, and we're highlighting Dr. Heather's work here. Thanks for tuning in.
On Earth Day.
On behalf of us we want to wish you, we'll let Dr. Heather say happy Earth Day to everybody.
Just a beautiful Earth Day, and like the kids are singing today, that everything runs in a circular motion. Life is like a dance between sun, air, land, and sea, and everybody is a part of everything anyway. Nature shows the way to set us all free, to give and receive life, to give and receive the beauty of love.
Love it.
Wow.
They learn that love grows in our garden.
That's right. Well, thank you so much for tuning in.
Thank you.
Thank you. And actually, we have one more request. We're going to stop by the 96th Street campus where I hear the cactuses have bloomed today on Earth Day.
Yeah, for the first time, and they were as big as your face. I could not believe it. They were so beautiful.
And what are the, well, let's talk about that. Isn't that a great coincidence that it happened on Earth Day?
Yes.
And they only bloom once a year.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you, Selena. Selena's tuning in with us here. Thank you. She wrote to Dr. Heather, thank you for setting a wonderful example. Love your heart and passion. Happy Earth Day. Thank you, Selena.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you. And we love all the kids at this campus, and we love our Mission Montessori family. We are so, so incredibly blessed to all be working together. Everybody works so hard for the sake of all the kids and all the parents, and we love you.
Cool. Well, thanks everyone for watching. Keep an eye out. We'll post a snapshot of those historic annual blooms.
Yeah.
And please like, share, and comment. Thank you, Mission family, for everything you do to support Montessori education. We are truly grateful for you.
Yes.
Happy Earth Day.